We haven't even got the data yet from using it 3 times a week for a month. But heart rate variability going up 30, 40%. I said to the doctor, that's a little disappointing. I hope it'd be. He goes, Mark, an athlete, professional athlete would pay $1 million for it to go up 5%. Hmm. It's just from better performance, better recovery. So heart rate variability, it affects your pulse comes down, your anxiety comes down, self-reported, you know, relaxing, feeling better, all those type of things come from the vagus nerve getting tone so that you're in balance. And heart rate variability, for those that don't know, and it's not intuitive if you're not familiar with it, having your heart rate come down is good. Lower pulse means you're more relaxed. You want your heart rate variability to actually go. It's the small milliseconds of difference between heartbeat intervals. So instead of being 1 second, it's 1.01, 0.99. And that sounds weird, but that is the best indicator for health, that your body is in tune for fight or flight, because you need to fight. You need to be in stress sometimes. We're usually overstressed and not in rest and digest mode. So that's what it does. It balances that vagus nerve, which is, it's kind of hit. It's a really translucent, it's a little tiny thing that we didn't know existed, you know, a few decades ago. It's not obvious like a heart, mm-hmm. but it goes to everything. It's connected to everything. And it's the super highway of communication between the brain and the